Jayshree Deshpande. Today we'll be discussing a topic in thermodynamics called entropy. Basically, entropy, by definition, it is quite simple. It is the degree of disorderness. Okay, so it changes when a phase gets changed. For a solid, which is a well-organized structure, the entropy is very less because it is already an ordered system. When it changes from solid to liquid or from liquid to gas, the entropy goes on changing, rather it will be increasing. Example, an ice will be having a very low entropy, liquid, like liquid water, will be having a higher entropy, and water vapor will be having still higher entropy. Before moving ahead into this topic, we need to discuss one more required part of it, called spontaneity. Okay, so what is the spontaneity concept in chemistry? Basically, spontaneity reaction or spontaneous reactions are a type of reactions which takes place on their own, which does not require any other external influence. So for this reaction to be spontaneous, you need to carry out it in a natural way. Like, you do not have to have any external influence on those reactions for carrying out this reaction. Rather, second law of thermodynamics has a corollary. We will be discussing about second law of thermodynamics after completing this. But the corollary says, second law of thermodynamics, the corollary of second law of thermodynamics is, all natural processes are spontaneous. Like, if I'm having milk, I want to convert it into curd. I do not have to do anything. It is just the thing, just the natural thing which drives it, and it gets converted into its product, which is curd in this case. So why did I discuss about spontaneous processes here? Because it is said that for a reactant and for a product, more stable, one of, like, amongst the both, one which is more stable, reaction tends to move towards it. Like, if I am having reactants at a higher energy level and I am having products at a lower energy level, reaction will be going towards the product side because they are at lower energy level. It means they are more stable. But what if I am having products at a higher energy state, which indicates they are less stable, and I am having products, I am having my reactants which is at a high, lower energy state, which indicates they are more stable. Reaction might go in the reverse way. So this is the thing which we need to have for the thermodynamic term called spontaneity. So let us take an example of a forward reaction wherein reactants are at higher energy state, products are at a lower energy state. So basically we need to remove energy from a reaction so that they will be converted to products. So for this, the type of reaction which is required is exothermic. Because if I liberate heat, my reactants will get converted to products. So which usually or which virtually means that all spontaneous processes should be exothermic. But friends, let me tell you, this is not the condition. Because if I take a simple example of ice getting converted to water, ice is a solid state which is having a lower, which is having a well-organized structure, which is, if it is converted to products, which is liquid water, will be obviously a higher energy state component. So this, for doing this, it has to absorb some energy, which is an endothermic process, but still it is spontaneous. So why is this difference? This will be shown, or this will be cleared, when we discuss a term called entropy. Let us discuss what entropy is by having its mathematical equation note. Entropy, which is also defined by a symbol called S. S is the thermodynamic symbol of it. As other thermodynamic properties like enthalpy and internal energy, individual entropy cannot be defined. Like, it cannot be defined instantaneously. It has to be defined over a change. So let me define delta S as Q reversible by T. Make a note, guys, it is not delta T, it is T, temperature. So what and why is this difference? Delta S, I am talking about a change in entropy. If I define delta S, it is basically S1 minus S2, wherein S1 indicates initial entropy, S2 indicates the final entropy which I have attained. So this Q reversible, we are aware of this term. Q is the heat transferred, reversible, because in thermodynamics the usual way of transferring heat is by reversible process. Irreversible process will not be dealing much into it. So as I'm giving in more heat, the change in that entropy will be more. Reason is, more the heat we put, more is the disordered molecules will be present, because the molecules will get more space to get disordered. So my Q reversible is more, like if I'm giving in more heat, my entropy change will be more, but obvious. What about this term called temperature? Basically, delta S or entropy change has an upper limit and a lower limit for any reaction. Let us consider a case wherein, suppose this is the S1, like initial entropy, and this is the S2, which is the final entropy. As I gave you an example of ice in the beginning, ice, water and water vapor. Let us consider only liquid water and water as ice. So if I am talking about ice, it is a solid state form, so the entropy present at that point will be very high, which is, let us say, S2, a final limit. And if I am talking about gaseous or water vapor or liquid water, whatever limit we are going to consider, that limit will be the highest limit, like entropy at that point will be the maximum. Beyond that, my entropy change is not applicable. So let us say this is that extreme level S1. So upper limits are S1 and S2. Ice should be at lower temperature, wherein water liquid will be at some medium temperature and water vapor will be at still higher temperature. So if I'm having a system at a low temperature, it indicates it will be having very low entropy. And if I'm having a system at a higher temperature, it will be having higher entropy. So if I'm having a system at say temperature T1, which is low, my entropy will be somewhere at this point. And if I'm having a system say at that temperature called T2, which is higher than T1, my entropy will be at some point in there. So now if I want to change the entropy, if I'm already at this point, I have a very higher delta to be covered. So my change in entropy can be more. What if I'm already at a higher point? The change which I can make is a bit low. So if the change I want to talk about will be higher if I'm having a temp system at a lower temperature. That's why the change, this point is delta I. So the change in entropy is inversely proportional to temperature. Lower the temperature, higher is the delta S. And higher the temperature, lower is the delta S. That's why the equation delta S is Q reversible upon T. Let us check the units for this entropy. It's clear from the mathematical equation which has been given, it's Q reversible. Q is the heat or the energy, which usually has the unit of kilojoules. And temperature, which already we know, the SI unit of temperature used is Kelvin. So the delta S has got unit of kilojoules per Kelvin, which is different than the other thermodynamic properties called delta H, which got a unit of kilojoules. Sometimes it is also kilojoules per mole. It depends upon the system to be considered. Delta U, which is the internal energy, which has got a similar unit, kilojoules, or again sometimes it can be kilojoules per mole. So this is the differentiating word term used in case of thermodynamics, which is because of this temperature difference or the temperature value in the denominator. This was all about the entropy. Now based upon or depending upon this entropy, we have second law of thermodynamics, which states, that all or any of the spontaneous process, for any of the spontaneous process to take place, this delta S should always be positive. It indicates if I am having a spontaneous process taking place, it means without any external influence, the final entropy will always be greater as compared to the initial entropy. Means the products will be more disordered as compared to the reactants. It is clear because any process which is spontaneous will be done in a disordered way. So the final products will be disordered as compared to the initial reactants. So the statement of thermodynamics says delta S should be positive, means it should be greater than zero. But this is not this delta S is not for any system. This has to be there for the total entropy change of the of the surrounding or of the universe, I would say. So the total entropy change should be greater than zero. So what is this total entropy change? Because in thermodynamics basics, may we have two important terms: system and surrounding. So this total entropy change is the combination of system and that of the surrounding. So delta S total
is basically delta S system plus delta S surrounding, which is many times called delta S universe. And this delta S universe, I would use the term total as it is used in many of the reference books as well. So delta S total should be greater than zero for the system to be spontaneous. This was about the second law of thermodynamics. Also, while discussing these terms, there are some limits or there are some conditions which also needs to be discussed. Like, it is okay if the system is spontaneous. What if I'm having non-spontaneous systems or which needs to be done in some with some external influence? What is the condition? Rather, I would say this should be greater than or equal to zero, because if the entropy change is equal, if it is equal to zero, the system can be at equilibrium, which can also be called as an equilibrium system. So let us check the difference between greater than and greater than or equal to. So the very first condition, what happens if my entropy change, total entropy change, greater than zero? As discussed earlier, if it is greater than zero, my system will be spontaneous process. So it is but obvious if my change in entropy delta S total, if it is less than zero, my system will go to non-spontaneous. So what happens when my delta S total is exactly equal to zero? It is said that when my entropy change is exactly equal to zero, my system has attained an equilibrium. It means my reactants will get converted to products and my products also will get converted to reactants, but the rate of both will be same. So net reaction will stop at that point. So when this is equal to zero, my reaction will be at equilibrium. So guys, this is all about entropy and the changes which are being seen in this reaction. Keep watching for next upcoming videos. Thanks a lot.